Maccabees. Rededicate your temple like the Maccabees. Like the Maccabees. Like the Maccabees. Like the Maccabees. Lineage of royal priests. Like the Maccabees. Like the Maccabees. Like the Maccabees. Lineage of royal priests.
Okay. Isaiah 1 and 3. What's your nationality?
Filipino.
Okay. Isaiah 1 and 3.
Isaiah chapter 1, verse 3.
First give me Romans 8 and verse 16. Okay? Because just because you're not, you have to be on his side to be considered an Israelite. God's chosen people. But over the years, we have been what they call mixing, which is not really true, but we've been, you could be an Israelite, okay? But I'm going to read the scripture. Watch this.
Romans chapter 8, verse 16. The spirit itself bears witness with our spirit.
The spirit itself bears witness with the Bible. So your spirit is going to bear witness with what we bring out. And if it does, you could be an Israelite. And if not, then you probably not. Right? Read.
That we are the children of God.
Right. That we are the children of God. Now, you said you're black and you said you're black. Can I find that term in the Bible? Slim, you on. Can I find the term black in the Bible? No, right? Can I find the term black in the Bible? You, brother, no. You believe in the Bible? You don't? Why you don't believe in the Bible? If you don't mind me asking. Yeah, get what is it? Proverbs 24? Psalm chapter 14, verse 1. Because you think it's a game. I know you think it's a game. And I know you see so-called black people up here, and you think it's funny. Is it funny the condition that your people are in? That's the question I have for you. Your people getting shot down in the streets. Last high and first fight, is that funny to you?
Right.
Do you find that funny? It's entertaining to you? Okay, I didn't think so. Read that.
The fool has said in his heart.
The fool says in his heart, read.
There is no God.
Uh-huh.
They are corrupt.
They are what?
They are corrupt.
They are what?
They are corrupt.
You corrupt, brother.
Yes.
You are corrupt. The Bible says that. Read.
They have done abominable works.
They have done abominable works. You know what the abominable works that you've done? Deuteronomy 7:3. I'm going to show you. Galatians 6-7. Right, yes. Matter of fact, get that first. Get Galatians 6-7 first. Get that first. Read that.
The book of Galatians, chapter 6, verse 7.
Uh-huh.
Be not deceived. God is not mocked.
One thing about it, you may laugh. You may think it's a joke. You may think it's funny. But the Most High God will not be mocked.
That's right.
Please understand that. You've been mocked too with the little smirk in your face. Read.
For whatsoever man sows, that shall he also reap.
Uh-huh. So what you sow is what you're going to reap.
Right.
Every man going to be judged by their works.
Right.
Every single man on the earth got to sit before Christ in the judgment seat. All
right? Right.
Now, get Deuteronomy 7:3. This is the sin that this brother's in. And he thinks it's a game. Come on.
Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 3. Neither shall thou make marriages with them.
Now, it says, neither shall thou make marriages with them. It's talking about the other nations outside of your people.
Right.
Because the question is, if you love your people, won't you marry within your own people?
Right. Yeah.
Right? You're going to marry within your own people. Read it again from the top.
Neither shall thou make marriages with them.
Uh-huh.
Thy daughter thou shalt not give unto his son,
uh-huh.
Nor his daughter shalt thou take unto thy son.
You see that? Y'all shouldn't be even. Are you married? You married to her? That's your wife?
Okay, keep reading. For they will turn away thy son from following me.
Why? Because she's going to turn you away from following God.
Right.
Now you up here thinking it's a game.
Right.
When we bring out the scriptures. That's a reflection of you and your marriage with this woman.
Right.
Who, according to the Bible, whether you like this or not, she's considered a heathen.
Right.
That's what she's considered.
Right.
Whether she got a cross on her arm or the praying hands, which is foolishness, we're not even supposed to pray like that. Right? Read it again.
For they will turn away thy son from following me, that they may serve other God.
That they may serve other God. I guarantee you this brother celebrates Christmas.
Right.
I guarantee you this brother celebrates Thanksgiving.
Right.
I guarantee you he's going to celebrate Memorial Day.
Right.
Right. All the things that the so-called white man has given us, he celebrates.
Right.
Why? Yeah. Because his wife celebrates it.
Right.
So it's only right that he going to celebrate it too. Read it again.
For they will turn away thy son from following me, that they may serve other gods.
That they may serve other gods. Come on.
So will the anger of the Lord be kindled against you.
Read that part again.
So will the anger of the Lord be kindled against you.
How you doing, sis? You heard that. You've been marked. How you doing, ma'am? I got a question for you. What's your nationality according to the Bible? We're Israel united in Christ. We teach our people who they are according to the Bible and how to get right with God. So, sometimes we might come across as being, say it again, aggressive, right? But it's the zeal that we have for God. It's the zeal that when we see our people in the condition that they're in, we get upset. We get angry, right? So that's the aggression that you see. I'm not going to see my people in the condition that they're in and laugh and think it's the game. That's just not, the spirit is off. Because ain't nothing to be happy about.
That's right.
We're supposed to be in rulership.
That's right.
Do you understand that? So, sister, what's your name?
Terry.
What's your nationality? African American. Okay. Do you know where the term African American comes from? Yes. It comes from two so-called white people. Leo Skippy's Africanus, right? And what's the other one? Amerigo Vespucci, okay?
The son of everybody. Remember that?
Yeah, the information's on there, yes. Alright? Okay, let me give you one law before you leave. Alright, one law. Deuteronomy 25.
Go!
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22, verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
The scripture says a woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man. Okay? It's talking about clothing, right? Read.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment. Which would be what? What would a man put on that pertains to a woman?
Clothing.
A dress, right? So what is something that pertains a woman that she would wear that pertains to a man that she's not supposed to wear? Say it again?
Hands.
That to the Most High is considered cross-dressing.
Right.
Why? Because you have on a pair of pants and you have a what? You have a zipper in your pants. Right? Most jeans and pants have on a zipper. What do you have a zipper for? It doesn't pertain to a man, but most jeans do. Most pants that women wear have a zipper in the front. That pertains to a man.
Daniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.